Central New York has become this area where money is being infused to support drone-related entrepreneurship and research. And so part of this was having some funding made available by an award from Griffin Sensors, facilitated by the College of Engineering.
The Geography Department put in a proposal, and so did the Earth Science Department separately. And then the engineers basically put us together.
We had about 6 months to do a bunch of work, and I think that got everybody excited. And then the question was, what comes next?
Krista and I started working together, trying to look at different applications for drones and thinking about curriculum.
You need permission to fly, permission from air traffic control.
The class is an introduction to unmanned aerial systems.
Our goals are to teach them about the regulations and kind of the legal frameworks governing some of these tools, as well as to actually get them engaged in taking some of the data and processing them to create some final deliverables so they could walk away with a website, a few images, some maps that actually show their ability to use these data and to interpret them.
And then you wind up with these projects that you couldn't have dreamed would happen. So we're really excited to see the result of the projects at the end of the semester.
We have students from Earth Sciences and Geography primarily, both at the undergraduate and graduate level. We also have students from ESF. And we have a couple students, you know, sprinkled around the university, some engineering students as well. So it's a nice interdisciplinary mix.
I absolutely think it's a game changer, especially just it makes it easier to do field work and be able to collect more data and open up faculty and grad students to more projects.
I study sediments forming in lake environments, and I'm particularly interested in a type of rock formation called a limestone. Limestones form in all types of environments, aquatic environments. In lakes, they're particularly unique and interesting, and we can use them for environmental records. They're very difficult to kind of study. Some of them are inaccessible due to where they're located. And so we're using drones to actually fly around these rock formations and build three-dimensional models of them that I can then use for other products down the line.
I would really love to have students producing deliverables that not only might have some research relevance, but could also be used by other local industries. So in moving forward, I think thinking about some of those partnerships and really showing students the opportunities these tools can lead to.
I think drones represent a really great opportunity for young people in the region, high school students, undergrads, grads, and I think they could be a way to help try to keep some of our young people in this region.